Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we built the ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wireless, wired, Active Directory and much more. So in our previous videos we enabled profiling and we even had a session on how to verify it with a packet capture. What we mentioned is that profiling, we needed that for the devices that can't do .1x authentication, like IP phones, like printers, like IoT devices, and in order to make that work, we need to configure MAC authentication. And to make that work, we first need to do some configuration on the switch. The configuration on the switch is similar to the .1x authentication, so we need to configure the server group to be used for MAC authentication, and we need to enable it on the network ports. So let's copy this configuration and configure that on the switch. And now we can test it. I do have a VoIP phone here and I'm plugging it in right now. So let's check what is the authentication status on the switch. You can see Windows client is still on port 113. This phone is booting up, so it will take some time before it comes online. So let's check. We can see that the interface 117, it's up physically. And now we can see the authentication is in progress. But we don't see any authentication coming into the ClearPass server at the moment. So why is that? So on AOS-CX there is an authentication order which is configured by default. So it will first try to do 802.1x, and only if there is a timeout, so no 802.1x client, then it will do a MAC authentication by default. I will fast forward the video. And then we can see that it took roughly 2 minutes and 30 seconds for the switch to fall back to MAC authentication, which is not so convenient. Also, we see now the authentication coming back in the access tracker. It's a failed authentication and we can see that the service is empty. So that's not an issue because we didn't configure the service yet. So that's why it doesn't have any service. We'll fix that later on in the video. However, for the authentication, we can change the order. So we could do MAC authentication first and .1x after, but maybe better, there is an option called concurrent onboarding, which was added after the wired solution guide for ClearPass was written. So that's why it's not in that guide. What concurrent onboarding can do, it can similarly to the previous Aruba OS switches. So it will try both at the same time. And then if there is a .1x authentication, that will take precedence according to the configuration over a MAC authentication. So this is the command that we need to enter for concurrent onboarding. You can see we also need to configure that on the switch ports. And now that it is configured, let's re-plug the phone. You can see now we have a MAC authentication. However, this is my Windows client. For the Windows client, we see both a MAC authentication and later on we will see a .1x authentication. And there we can see the MAC authentication for our clients. So we can see the delays are much smaller, and as an end user experience, that's probably much better. Right, so as promised, we will now create our MAC authentication service. We see here is our AOS-CX wired service already, which is for .1x, and we just create a new service. So the type will be MAC authentication. Let's give it a name, AOS-CX wired MAC, and put in a description. And let's take the profile endpoint option here. As you can see, there appears another tab, profiler, in the service workflow. And as all the services are processed from left to the right, we'll get to that in a minute. But first, let's go into the authentication. So the default authentication method is allow all MAC authentication. In previous versions, that was MAC authentication. I always changed it back to allow all MAC authentication. So it's good that it's now the default. The main difference between MAC authentication and allow all MAC authentication is that for MAC authentication, you have seen in the endpoint database, we have the endpoint status, which can be known, unknown, or disabled. For the MAC auth, without the allow all, it will only authenticate devices that have the status of known. And for the allow all, it will just allow any MAC address for authentication. And then later on in the workflow, you can configure what you want to do with the devices. So in most cases, that is what you want, the allow all MAC authentication. So the authentication source will take the endpoint repository for that, so we can use the profiling information during our policy. And let's skip the role mapping for now. And let's leave the enforcement to allow all. We'll configure this later on. We'll do it step by step. Then in the profiler tab, what we can configure here is what ClearPass should do in case there is new profiling information. So let's assume we have a new device and ClearPass doesn't know the device type yet. At that point, we can allow that device on a network in a profiling role, so very limited access, so we can just do the profiling. But then, once ClearPass has received the DHCP fingerprint, has profiled the device, we want to trigger the process from the start and get it assigned to the correct VLAN and role for that device. And that's what we configure here. So the radius COA action, that is what ClearPass will trigger. So switch port bound sounds like a good one for me. And we need to select for which endpoint classifications that COA action should happen. We can limit it to certain devices like just phones or printers. Or we can just trigger it on any new or changed profiling event. And that's what I select here. So let me change the name of the .1x wired service to make it clear which service is what. And now it's time to disconnect and reconnect our phone. Again, the phone will take a few seconds to boot up. And there we see the authentication. And if we check in the access tracker, what we can see is that profiling information is unknown at this point. That is because the ClearPass has not seen this device before. And if we go out, we see another authentication. And that is because the port bounce happened after the phone was profiled by the ClearPass. And when we go in the first authentication again, we see that now the device type is updated to VoIP phone. And we can see there is a radius dynamic authorization tab that shows the information about the automatic COA action that was fired. And the port bounce, it was successful. And if we now check our most recent authentication, that also shows the device type and a simple allow access profile. And this is something that we can take up in the next video, where we will create additional roles on our AOS-CX switches for these devices and also create a more useful policy based on the device profiling. I hope this was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and also subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment section below the video or join the Airheads community at community.arubanetworks.com. Thanks for watching.